Okay. As per the my scripture, which is great from a given by great God, Brahman is all Shaktiman. I can't even lift this chair. Okay. So such doubt starts coming. Okay. To clarify that doubt is called manana. So he said, Brahman alone is there. How come I have husband and my two kids are there at home? Wife is there. So there are three. Are there three Brahmans? This doubt starts coming. Okay, that doubt has coming because your clarity has not emerged. Brahman means Sakshi. Sakshi is one. Oh, no, even I understood Sakshi. Then if I Sakshi means I should understand what's happening in your mind. That will be better, very nice. Then you didn't understand the word called Sakshi. Are you clear? So the clarity has to emerge very deeply. Ultimately, you, the Guru and Vedanta should be in sync. If that is not, syncing is not happening, either Shravana is not proper. If Shravana is proper, Manana is not proper. Now why Manana problem became problem? Because your previous vasanas. Guru will not remove your previous vasanas. Okay, it's not job of the Guru to remove the previous vasanas. He can give, tell you what is right. Okay? What a proper jnana he can give. Now, the proper jnana you start applying, your previous vasanas will come. A strong vasana and the body will come. Okay? And I am the body of Guru, vasana starts creating a doubt. Brahman alone is reality. Oh, there are three people here. Because he started cleaning his body, because your vasanas are there. Understand? So, then you have to clarify. How do you clarify? You listen to talks of Guru. Again, again, reinforce. Okay? Or ask Guru question. Finally, you get a clarity. Yes, Subhu.
I have a question. So if you understand the individuality is not real, but still in the waking state, there's a feeling of individuality is still there.
There's no feeling. It'll come to that. The feeling also vasana.
It's a vasana. So will that feeling go away by Shravana or it's a vasana which has to...
It'll go to manana and nidhyasa. Okay? Nididhyasa will remove the feeling. Right? Okay? So now, manana and nididhyasa is to remove your earlier vasana so that new jnana will get deep. Jnana or mukti is only Shravana Matra. Okay? Manana and Nididhyasa is a cleaning up process. Atma Jnana is through Shravana. Have you understood the difference? Okay. So I'll give you an example which our man from Chennai will understand. Okay, Chennai was called Madras earlier. Every day you write Madras, 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 Babu, okay, all Madrasi, and North Indians will actually say, this guy is a Madrasi, okay, typical, they have a Madrasi brand. Then one day, government of Chennai, government of Madras decided the Madras will be called Chennai. All newspaper published, Madras will be Chennai. Okay? So that's actually Jnana from Guru. But you go home, you start writing a letter. Instead of Chennai, you write Madras. Why did it happen? Because Madras name is Vasana is already there. Madras Vasana is there. Madras Vasana has not gone. Then you start feeling, why this fellow has called Chennai Madras? Madras is such a nice name. You hate the Chennai fellow name also. How come this government has no job actually? Rather than improving the life of people, they are changing the names. Their vasanas are starting to come in. Madras vasanas. Okay? Right?
This Madras Chennai is a
Vachapada.
And the actual city land is actually Brahman.
So, I am just giving the example, right? Nana has come. Nana in this, I mean analogy. Don't make it exact. Analogy is... Government is like a guru. One day they decided Chennai is, Madras is Chennai. Now you understood. Madras is Chennai. Understanding is over. But go home, again you'll write Madras only.
Right, application.
While applying, your vasanas will come. Okay? And many people outside city, they don't even know Chennai has happened. They'll write, keep writing Madras. So then while replying also, you'll start, instead of using word Chennai, you'll use Madras because they don't understand. Madras Vasana has not gone. Okay? It will take time. So, Jnana is one time. Vasana removal is a process. You have to get adjusted to the new status. Okay? That adjusted to new status is called Manana and Nididhyasana. Okay? Got it? If you are under the impression that one day I'll do 10,000 hours of meditation, I'll get a Jnana. No. In the presence of Guru, you get a Jnana. If you didn't get it, you will not get it through meditation. Because if you close your eyes, only vasanas will come, no Jnana will come. Understand? Is this much clear?
Yeah.
So, Manana and Nididhyasa is a process of cleaning up the vasana. Equivalent of in Chennai, I am saying. Okay? So, one day you don't change the name Chennai. Now, next time you say, I forgot the name Chennai. So, then in a paper, a piece of paper, I'll write, Chennai is Madras, Chennai is Madras, Chennai is Madras. You write some 10 times. Okay? To make sure that the Chennai Madras vasana goes. Still there.
You keep mentioning it.
So some people have some strong vasana of Madras because of Madras coffee or Madras interest, something like that. So then vasanas you have to remove. But Jnana is one time, vasana removal is a process. Okay? Clear? Jnana is called enlightenment. One time. Vasana removal is called liberation from vasana. Okay? If you get a Jnana clearly, you are already become Jivan Mukta. Vasana is a process. It will go slowly. If you are understanding that one day I will become Jivan Mukta, I will sit like Ramana Maharshi and people fall at my feet. Okay? Right? Some radiation will come from my head. Nothing like that will happen. No miracle will happen. Jnana is a clarity. That's called, it's why it's called enlightenment. It's clarity. So enlightenment word also artists have converted very nicely. Artists have very imaginative word. They'll put a light in front of it. Actually, I also ordered one 100-candle bulb which can put here. It can give light. See, the artists have added another confusion. Anything in spirituality they convert into imagination. Then people start looking for that light. For artists, somebody who has actually thought over a long time, for them they can't say how much person spent. Then they put so the person with a beard. Because this person has spent so much of time without shaving his beard, that's why his time is converted into beard in the form of artist. And now all the people will start looking for that. Jnana means he has to have a big beard. So artists, they want a pictureless issue, no? So the person is very happy. How do they show? Okay, they show the big stomach. Big stomach means happiness, ananda. So people think that, okay, this person. So Ganesha actually is a full of ananda. Then they cannot put a big stomach. Now people understood. Big stomach means Ganesha is obesity. You keep on feeding him all the mandu karma. What is that? Let's do that. Artist's way of communicating happiness was through big stomach. Your way of understanding big stomach is obesity. Right? That's why there is Jain Upanishad, Jain teaching. Mahavira got enlightened. Okay, then he was going and a thorn got into his leg. He removed the thorn. Instead of blood, milk started coming. Okay. So this actually, Osho was invited for the first time. Actually, it's not famous. He was invited to a Swamiji's talk. Swamiji said, after enlightenment, person's blood will become milk. This is understanding. That person was very famous Swamiji. Then the whole auditorium was full because they had come to listen to Swamiji. He was very famous. Osho was not famous. Everybody started getting. Osho is a new guy that time. Then Osho got up. Okay, he said, you have listened for 2 hours for a fool talking. Give a wise man to talk 10 minutes. If you are not happy, then go. Okay. Then people got shocked. And the Swamiji got very shocked actually. They sat. And then, no, enlightenment doesn't convert blood into milk. Okay. Right. So actually, the milk is a symbol of purity and peace. that purity and pace has gone throughout his body. That's why symbolically by a poet shown as a milk. And this Swamiji thinks that milk is the reality. What type of Swamiji is that? And actually it so happened that Swamiji got so angry, he hired killers to kill Osho that time. That's Jain Swamiji. Okay, so like artists will depict some way of truth, that we will start imagining that. Then poets will depict truth in some way, then we will start imagining that. We get stuck in that cultural conditioning, artists conditioning. Artists also create big maya. And
it's artists... also an example of that watcher.
Vachabarna is
ornament.
Okay. So now you have to, any enlightened being, you have to have at least 1 feet beard. Otherwise you can't. That 1 feet beard was a way of artist showing this person has thought a lot of time without shaving also, yes. Like that. Okay. What? What did you say? What? Okay. Understand. Manana and Nididhyasa is to clean up your earlier vasanas. Guru will not do the job. That's not his job. Guru's job is only to give surgery. Vasana removal is your job. Go and sit and clean up the vasana. Okay? That's called manana nididhyasa. Right? So now I am not enlightened. It's a vasana. Enlightenment only, please understand, enlightenment is only, it's not an experience. It's a clarity. Enlightenment is not experience. Everything in life is experience. Enlightenment is not experience.
Clarity in mind.
Where is kidney can have clarity?
There is realization we say.
The realization is real I. What is that? Whatever you have understood so far is the only real I. Now anything which is coming interfering there is called vasana. Enlightenment is never an experience.
Understanding.
It's a
but many enlightened people about special effects and it is just false or it is like case by case it
depends. Okay. Sri Shankaracharya, this is called Shankara Digvijaya. If you read lot of things, okay, there are so many things which are happening, this miracle, that miracle. The Shankara Digvijaya was only written after 300 years after Shankaracharya to give importance to Shankaracharya in Indian life. Now how much reality is there? You present. Bible, okay, whatever is there in Bible, was completely rewritten in 8th century by a king called Constantine. Actually, Bible is not spoken word of Christ. Bible is political document of Constantine.
King Arthur.
He was there in Constantine place. So, don't get into illusion. Go to real Vedantic truths. Vedanta says enlightenment is not an experience. I am not experienced. That means you are not understood Vedanta. You have to get a clarity. Adnana has to go. Then, your vasanas you have to correct. Okay? Vasana correction is your effort. Post-dnana. Jnana is called enlightenment, vasana liberation is called liberation. Is it not clear? Any doubts? So if you don't remember this, just remember Madras becomes Chennai. Okay? So jnana means jama brahma satya jagan nitya aham brahmasmi sarvam khalu ida brahma. Finally, all this has to be Brahman. The clarity has to emerge, okay? It's not experience has to emerge, it's clarity has to emerge. Okay? What is it? Okay? So I am pure consciousness, body and world is appearance in consciousness. Doubts arise. Doubts arise because of incorrect understanding or vasana. Through self-study, discussion with the master, you have to clarify the doubts. Very clear?
Where is this theory?
Okay. Or made up, who was it? 1:30? Okay. You go, carry on.
It's
okay. No, it's not okay.
No, but it is just some practice. You said we'll have some practice also, right?
So, yeah, I'm getting
just
ready.
To give it
just check up. We are spending too much of time in the problem rather than going to solution. That's all. Okay. So, manana, shravana means listening clearly. Okay. What is the condition required for listening clearly? Okay. What is the condition required for shravana clearly? Guru should be
realized.
It's called Brahmanishta.
And he should be able to communicate.
Okay. Just because he is Brahmanishta, not necessarily he can't. He should be able to communicate. Okay. It's called what is called? It's called Shrotriya. Through Yukti or Prakriya. He has to come down to your level of understanding to teach. Okay? Not necessary. Not necessary. Learning, a person without learning also, he has done, is okay. He's able to communicate.
Tell about Shishyas.
Yeah. Shishya, what is should you ask for Shishya?
Listen properly and
practice. What should be quality of Shishya, you tell me?
Trust.
It's called trust. Actually, there's these words are trust, faith, and belief. Faith, trust, faith, and belief. Okay, they are different things. So I have given a detailed lecture about the difference between trust, faith, and belief. Also, Shishya should have trust. I can say it's not a real word. Faith. Faith is called Shraddha. In whom?
Guru.
Guru's teaching.
Guru's teaching and Vedanta. If you don't believe Vedanta, it doesn't work for you. Vedanta means the Vedanta is telling the ultimate truth if you don't have belief. If only Bible will teach ultimately, this will not work for you.
So if you don't know anything about Vedanta?
No, no.
If you come directly?
Yeah. You come directly because of the Guru. Okay, that's fine.
But why are you required to be believing Vedanta?
No, no. See, how do you believe a guru is good? There are so many gurus now. So much of confusion is caused. Why? Everybody says, I know something.
Because they say something, do something, your understanding is not there. Clarity is not there.
So, that's what is the reason is confusion is created in the world.
Result is not coming.
Because ultimately, guru's teaching, Vedanta teaching, there should be cross-reference. It cannot be somebody does something. Okay, then surrender should be there in Shishya. What is the surrender? Catch hold of feet of Guru and don't leave. What is Sharanagati?
Surrender.
What is the surrender of ego? Ego is also a big word.
Unconditional.
What is that surrender? Gayatri?
Understand whatever he has
done. Give up that saying, I am the body and...
So, shifting surrender means
shifting.
Give up your past. And future. Imaginations. Okay. Worries. Imaginations. Okay. all those things you give up. Because you trust that this will lead to, say, for example, okay, a blind man comes and doctor says, I do operate your eyes and you will be able to see tomorrow. Then blind man says, what will I do with my walking stick? I purchased it for 1,000 rupees yesterday. So you don't need it. Okay, so this trust is, don't offer to Guru fruits or something. Offer your worries, anxieties and imaginations. Just drop them. That's surrender. Okay. Let us do the practice now. Nimiratu. Manana and Nididhyasa. Nididhyasa means a practice. It is actually the practice is called Nididhyasa, which is Samadhi practice. There are two types of Samadhi. Okay? Bahya Samadhi and Antara Samadhi. And please understand, Samadhi practice will not give you Jnana. Samadhi practice will remove you Vasanas. Okay? So you had a Vasana called earlier, I am the body. Now you have to replace the body Vasana called, I am the Sakshi. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ ಈಗ ಹೊಸ ವಾಸನೆ ತುಂಬಬೇಕು ಏನೋ ನಾನು ಸಾಕ್ಷಿ ಅಂತ ವಾಸನೆ ತುಂಬಬೇಕು ರೈಟ್ ಮುಂಚೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಐ ಆಮ್ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ವಾಸನೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಐ ಆಮ್ ದಿ ಸಾಕ್ಷಿ ಅಂತ ವಾಸನೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ವಾಸನ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸಾಕ್ಷಿ ವೇರ್ ದರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ವಾಸನ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ ದ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ There are hundreds and thousands of people will keep you reminding every day you are a body. Nobody will remind you over Sakshi.
That's true.
Who has to remind you you are Sakshi?
Ourselves.
You only have to remember, you have to repair yourself. The world will not come. Only two people, one guru will do and you have to do. Remind you are a Sakshi. Okay? Then you have to remember you are a Brahman. Is it okay? This is called Nididhyasa. I am Sakshi. I am Brahman. Okay? Is it clear, Kathin? Nobody will remind you are Sakshi. In fact, you have to remember you are again and again. Vasana, you have to remember. But I am the body Vasana. Okay? So, how do you do that? Right? This is, the example is, you go to airport. Somebody is coming. Your friend has picked up. Somebody has told you, friend, pick up my friend. You don't know his friend. Then you call up. Hey, this person is coming. He looks, he has a big mush. Is he your friend? No, my friend has no mush. Okay? He is carrying a suitcase in it. No, my friend doesn't carry a suitcase. He carries a bag. So, first is rejection. No. Then this person is coming with a wife. My friend is coming with a wife. So, then matching. First is no. Matching. Then, perfect match is the silence. Nididhyasa process is first is no. Matching, then silence. Okay? So let us take up the first process called Bahya Nididhyasa. What do you see in this picture? What is that? What is that in the picture?
There are three cows.
Cows are there, right? So, for Nididhyasa purpose, you have to go from Vishesha Lakshana to Samanya Lakshana. Okay? So, let us understand. What do you see in this picture?
Different animals, river, mountain.
Animals are there, right? Okay? So, what is common in this picture? Sudha?
All
animals have brown color. Okay, what else is common?
Animals are probably looking for water.
They are looking for water is common. What else is common?
Nature
is common to all or nature is also background? Okay. Now please remember this word. Can you repeat with me? To find Brahman. I have to go. I have to find the commonness.
The commonness.
Okay. Then you found Brahman.
They all exist.
So the tiger exists. Oh, sorry, what is that? The fox exists. Okay. The greenery exists. The eagle exists. Right. The mountain exists. The river exists. So what is common in all of this?
Existence.
Do you exist?
Yes.
I am common.
No, no. Existence is common.
But existence is coming from my beingness only.
So, is this clear to all of you? Existence is there, which is common to all. So the Vishesha Lakshana means special characteristic. What is the Vishesha Lakshana of a fox?
Name and form.
There is a name and form.
Color, name, form.
Color is there. Right? So, first practice of Samadhi is keep removing the Vishesha Lakshana and go back to the existence. Okay? Then the moment you go back to the existence, that existence is Brahman. It's called Sat. Understand? So you have heard the word called God exists everywhere?
Yes.
God is everywhere?
Yes.
Now you understand what is God everywhere? God means?
Existence is there everywhere.
Existence is God. The sky exists. The wind exists. The forest exists. The tree exists. I exist. Are we clear? But I has a special characteristic called I am aware. I am. Okay? Existence itself is not known until the consciousness is there, which is I am. So you cannot separate out existence from consciousness. Consciousness is there, but existence is not there, then you can't understand. So existence plus consciousness is God. And I am that existence. Now am I finite or infinite?
Infinite.
Infinite.
Because there's no border, no. Can there be a border between the existence? No, this chair exists and that table exists. That chair exists and that chair. Is it continuous or discontinuous?
Continuous. Existence is continuous.
How?
The gap is also existence.
This exists, that exists.
Space.
In between the space exists. Existence cannot be broken. Okay? So first you have to say, no, neti neti. All specific characteristics you have to remove. Okay? And please understand, all specific characteristics only come from your name, or mind, thought. Neti, neti, neti. Then you go to common characteristic, existence, and I am conscious. Then hold on to the concept that I am existence. I am Brahman. Okay? Right? Okay, now what happened? All thoughts are gone now. What is thought there now?
I am Brahman.
So now you don't know the Brahman, because Brahman cannot be known. But Brahman can be pointed out. The Brahman nature can be pointed out. Right? So what is the nature of existence? Is existence infinite?
Yes.
Infinite.
Right? So I am infinite. Now you have everything you have to replace. Don't go to Brahman. Again, another name you're bringing. I am
infinite.
Because I am existence. I am, there's no breakage in me. Akhanda.
Space.
Indivisible. Okay? Akhanda. Then, when did the existence start? The name and form started. Existence started before time. Anadi. Ananta. Continue reading late. Huh? We are close. Right? So like that, characteristics of Brahman you have to remember. Brahman has no characteristics. But you are describing Brahman so that your vasanas will go. Okay? Earlier vasana is, I am limited. I am body. Okay? I am mind. Now these vasanas you are replacing with the?
I am infinite.
I am infinite. Akanda, Ananta. Okay? Then any thought comes, you have to know. You have to hold on to truth. Now, how long you have to hold on to truth? So, by holding on to truth, your mind will become silent. Then don't have to hold on, don't have to think. Then you already entered into Brahman. Stay there. Again, vasanas will come. So, I am so and so, name will come. Again, you go back to Brahman. Is it clear, Kathini? Huh? Is the process clear? Now, you don't have to imagine actually. You have to just hold on to thought. Okay? So, this our ancient ancestors, ancient people told very beautifully, Om Namah Shivaya. Om is Brahman. Na is space. Ma is wind. Shi is fire. Va is water. Ya is earth. Om Namah Shivaya means, I am all pervading. Okay? So, then if you go inside, I am consciousness, Shivoham. Whatever you observe is Shakti, Om Namah Shivaya, which is existence. I am Shiva, Shivoham. Is it clear? Okay. So, what we do is, when sitting for meditation, we'll use the mantra Om Namah Shivaya. Don't keep on repeating. Om Namah Shivaya mantra you take. Any thought comes, remember the I am existence. I am Shiva, Shivoham. Existence Akanda, Ananta, Anadi, Sanatana. Okay? So these are the four characteristics you may remember. Akanda,
Akanda,
Ananta,
Ananda,
Anadi,
Anadi,
Sanatana,
Sanatana,
Brahma,
Brahma,
Shivoham,
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 Shivoham.
You don't take multiple characteristics also, just take one characteristic, infinite. Ananta. Like that. Remember your nature. Akanda.
Akanda.
Ananta.
Ananda.
Anadi.
Anadi.
Sanatana Brahma.
Sanatana Brahma.
So by doing this meditation, okay, your mind will become more and more silent. So then when a silent mind from conscious mind to subconscious mind, unconscious mind, it has gone. Just like you have programmed vasana called I am the body, now the programmed vasana called I am Brahma will come. Is this clear to all? Is clear to all?
Yes.
Now you don't have to consciously think. Just like you have programmed yourself, who programmed yourself? You are the body. Please tell me. You didn't Vasanas. Program. Society.
Okay.
Everybody started treating as body, they got programmed. Okay? Deprogramming has to be done by you. Society will not deprogram you. Programming that you are a body, you are a girl, you are a man, beautiful, handsome, is done by society. It's unconscious. They consciously deprogramming you have to do. Okay. So we'll do in next class also continue this. Okay. We'll have one more class for this badge. Okay. We'll have one more class for this badge where I'll continue this what you call as oh this you brought as a final class, huh? Okay. So we'll repeat this next class. So we'll have one more class in December. So you have to hold on to the thought that I am Shiva. Just like you are holding on to thought I am the body. Now this will go and dissolve the vasanas. Jnana, enlightenment will not come. Enlightenment will only clarity, which is guru. But vasanas will get dissolved. Okay? Is it clear?
Sir, one clarity only. When you tell that, no, sir, there is only existence which is common. And the special thing is the name and form, sir. When you say name and form also, no? So, when you say name and form itself, or when you see that itself has to exist.
Yes.
So, still in name and form also, existence is always present.
Existence is there.
Name and form can't be there without existence.
Correct. Existence is basic. Existence is basic.
So name and form is also existence.
Yeah, but existence you cannot see.
Existence, I can't see because I am existence.
You are existence. You cannot see. Existence you can see only in name and form. What you see is not existence, but a name and form of the existence.
Name and form of existence. Huh?
Name and form. Existence appearing as name and form.
Appearing as name and form.
Existence, pure existence you can't see.
You can't, no. Yes.
Right? Because you are the pure existence.
It can be, but you can't see.
See it.
Can't objectively see it.
So is this clear process for all of you? Okay, so we'll do that. Is it clear, Radhini? Let's sit and meditate for some time now. Sit properly.
So first we do.